Ambolini is a point man going for more offense, but he doesn't very often get to carry the puck up the ice and start looking where you're going to dump it in. This is kind of a new thing for him right now, and that really wasn't his best dumping.
Here's Yanni for Canada. 28 seconds left in the penalty. Yanni flips it in. And again, Semyonov back to clear it. Billgren knocks it down, but big Semyonov came up with the puck to Svetlov, and the Soviets come to center. Svetlov moving in, gets it to Semyonov. He's too well checked by Yanni, and then jammed into the boards. Svetlov for the Soviets. Loses it, and back comes Yaremchuk. Makarov out of the penalty box. Pass to Zalewski. Shoots up high off the glass and right over the glass into the crowd. Meanwhile, the Soviets have killed off the penalty.
Well, the Soviets are doing a very, very good job. You know, they're so quick at getting back there. The Canadians trying to get in on top of them and hem them in. But Darley Zalewski got the pass there. Wasn't on his stick. He really had it. It was a bouncing puck. And by the time he was waiting for it to settle down, the Soviet defenseman got there and deflected that puck into the crowd.
Brad Park, you've been involved with the teams down 2-0 coming into the third period. What do we have to do to open this thing up and get a goal?
Well, it depends if you're down one goal or two goals or four goals. If you're down four goals, you try to get one every 5 minutes. If you're down two goals, which the Canadians are right now, you're looking at getting one in the first 10 minutes. And if you can accomplish that, that means you've got 10 minutes to tie this hockey game.
Here's Malinowski getting it to Tim Waters. Waters firing it in, and Byakin is back for the Soviets. To Kamienski. Randy Gregg skates him off. Bekov fires it in. Homotov in to get it. Couldn't. Now Gusarov in behind the net to Bekov. And he got upended by Waters. Bekov after it again. Into the corner. Homotov tries to center. Into the other corner. Kamienski bumping with Sherman. Kamienski gets the puck. Couldn't get it centered. Now Homotov tied up by Randy Gregg. Kamienski into the other corner. To Homotov. Gregg has him tied up before the puck ever got there. Now Bekov out in front. Wrap around backhand shot. Wide of the target. Gusarov into the corner. Canada's Sherman had it. Lost it. And some tough action on the boards inside Canada's blue line. Now Waters circles back. And over on the far side, Beery took out Byakin. And that allowed the puck to go down the ice. Bekov back to get it. Soviets leading 2-0. We're early in the third period. Here's Lomakin into the Canadian zone. Check. Canada clear it out to center, and Kasatonov back to get it. Shot it away. Here's Chris Felix to Yaremchuk. Canada on offense. Back to the point. Felix shooting. Milnikov the save. And the rebound cleared into center ice. Felix for Yaremchuk. Canada trying to attack again, but Tierney breaks it up. Back he comes. Leaves it for Mogilny, who shot the flex wide. Tierney a chance. That's blocked. And now Tambellini feeding it into center ice. But Patisov is back for the Soviets. His pass to number 21, Alexander Tierney. Tierney centered. Mogilny fans on it as he tried to spin around. And Zalewski, headman to Boisvert, to Yaremchuk at least. Tierney there to intercept that. And circling back is Krutov, number 9. Soviets leading 2-0 and in complete control at this point. Puck shot down the ice. Zalewski back, and that's icing against the Soviets. Let's look at the fireworks in downtown Calgary tonight.
Lots of them downtown. Not too much here in the Olympic Saddle, though. Just the 2 goals have been scored. Boy, that's a show, isn't it?
Loud last night. It is terrific.
Good. Good here in awe of that. Well, they know how to put on a party in this town, Dan.
That they do. That happens every evening around this time in Calgary. After the medal presentations, they have a laser show and then the fireworks. We'd like some fireworks here. But so far, the Soviets in control, leading 2-0. And they clear it into center ice. Hustling back after it is Tony Styles. Burke out of the net to play the puck. Fires it high off the glass, and Sherman poked it ahead to Berry. Berry checked by Krawczuk on the play. Now Styles jumped up, knocked it down, crosses the red line, and dumps it in. In comes Sherman. Now Hampshire. Shot behind the net. Styles trying to center a deflection by Hampshire, but off the target, and Makarov comes up with the puck. Look at him stick handle his way out of trouble. Now they drop it to Stelnov, who gives it to Makarov. Lost it. Chance for Zalewski, but Stelnov back defensively to Kurutov with Makarov. Only Waters back, and he poked it off the Soviet player's stick and took him out of the play, and Gord Sherman starts back. Into center ice to Hampshire. Hampshire trying to center. Broken up and cleared back out. Here's Kurutov to Makarov. Moving in, a chance, and missing with Semyonov as he went to his backhand. Now centered and off a skate. And Burke had to be sharp and alert on that one. Here's Schreiber for Canada. Intercepting on the blue line with Svetlov. Back into center ice for Svetlov. Into Yashin. Shot right on. Burke the save. Over on the far side for Svetlov. Back on the point. Shot wide of the net. And it's cleared around on the board by Trentjani. And coming up with it is Schreiber. For Yanni. Headmanning it ahead to Bradley. Into Boisvert. Centered. Put it right in front, but Schreiber couldn't try or get a stick on it for the deflection. And the Soviets come back. Yashin moving in on left wing. Taken out by Yanni. And Felix has it for Canada. Headmanning to Paplinski, who flies into the Soviet zone on left wing. Paplinski can't get it centered as he battles with Fetisov, and then the Soviets clear it out. This is Styles back to get it. Rolled off his stick and having to hustle back with Boisvert. Soviets, Ron, playing almost a letter-perfect game right here.
Well, right now they've just got Canada tied so completely up.
There's an offensive chance by Kamienski that Burke had to stop centered. And now Paplinski starts back. Kamienski held it in. To Homatov. Into Kamienski. Kamienski cuts in. Burke slid out, made the save. And Felix comes back for Canada. Demalinowski couldn't get it out of the zone. Felix back after it. Soviets leading 2-0. And seemingly in control right here. Felix starts back, fires it in. Fetisov back to get it. Loses Malinowski a chance. Check before he could shoot, and Fetisov blurring it. Bekov got it to center. Zalewski loses. Now McGillney giving it to Bekov. Bekov tied up by Zalewski and ridden up. Billgren over to get it. To Yaremchuk. And he circles his own goal. Yaremchuk lost it. Held in by Lomachen. Side of the net. McGillney shoots. He scores! The youngster McGillney to make it 3-0 for the Soviet Union.
Well, Canada just simply could not get out of its own zone. McGillney celebrating, of course, but they kept trying, and things would happen. They turn it over before they got to the line. Canada feeling the pressure of almost a full-court press, and here's McGillney just getting it alone inside of the net and putting it, I think, between the pads of Burke.
I think Sean...
Here's the turnover right here. That was the key to it.
I think Sean Burke was playing the pass. Watches McGillney gets the puck here. He comes in front. Now, Burke starts... He's turned sideways. Instead of just playing the shooter, he's turned sideways because he's thinking he's having to go to the other side. You can't fault him because the Soviets just had two excellent chances just before that by Kamienski and Semyonov. They've been in alone on Sean Burke, and he's starting to guess who's going to be free, who's going to get the open puck, and am I going to look bad?
I'll give hockey fans a tip. Remember that name, McGillney, for future international games. This is the youngster, and that's his second goal of this tournament. Lomachen assisting. 8 minutes the time. Gives the Soviets a 3-0 lead. Now Sherman for Canada drive. Rebound to Hampshire, but Milnikov able to hold it out. And it's cleared to center ice. Sherman has it there. Dropping it back for Trent Yanni.
Milnikov doesn't have much of a glove hand, but the way the defense is playing in front of him, it doesn't seem to matter.
Waters getting it to Sherman. It's shot in, and Larionov goes back to pick it up. Larionov beats one man, then feeds it to Stelnov into center ice. Soviets were going to change, but Kravchuk saw the pucks and then fired it in, and Burke gives it to Felix. Up the middle, missing Bradley, goes the length of the ice. Bjorken back to touch it, and that's icing against Canada. 11:01 to play, and the Soviets with a 3-0 lead.
Sherman, who had the chance in front of the net, watch for him, he's number 10, intercepted it at the blue line and then whistled it off the glove, tried to snap it, but then he covered up with Lertley. Canada needs a break on something like that. They're not getting them. Little line, you make your own breaks. Really not that tough around the net.
Dave King talking it up at Team Canada's bench. He felt his club almost had to win this game to stay alive, and I think we agree, Ron.
Well, they now really are up against it.
Loose puck. Burke comes out, cleared it. Knocked down. Gusarov now. The sweat lob in front. Semyonov just missed on the backhand. Here's Semyonov again. Now sweat lob out in front. Centered it. Bjorken a drive, and Burke kicked out his right pad to stop that. In the corner is Yashin, and he's tied up on the play by Felix. Puck came loose to the point. Gusarov shot it back in, and Felix and Yashin are still there. Now Semyonov. And it's Canada clearing it out of there. Third, Poivre flips it down into the Soviet zone with Semyonov back to get it. And Bjorken just clears it to the Canadian blue line. Poplinski back to Randy Gregg. Now to Poplinski again, but Gusarov there to ride him out. And Gregg goes back for Canada. Gregg lead pass. Kasatonov there to intercept. Over on left wing for Fetisov. Now shooting it ahead on right wing, and back is Balinowski for Canada. Canada trailing 3-0 and needing some offense badly at this point. Bekov to Kamienski. Shot wide of the target. And it bounces into center ice. Fetisov, who's been so dominant through these Olympics, shoots it in. Here's Bekov trying to center. Knocked down by Gregg. And back for Canada comes Tambellini. In for Vilgrov. He drops it back. Comes to Zalewski, but the shot blocked by Kamienski. And here comes Tomachev for the Soviets. Puts on the brakes. Tries to make a play. Does. Lomachen in front. Bekov is stopped by Burke from close in.
Don't fault Burke on this game. He has been outstanding.
Centered again. Kasatonov a shot, and that one blocked by Sherbin. And now Canada's Hampshire starts back. Not as far as center. Now Waters firing it in. And the Soviets go back.
Dan, I think the Soviets did smell a kill here right now. They're gonna run this score up. They got the Canadians backing in. The Canadians are trying to get some offense, making gambles. It's like they smell a kill and they want to go after them.
3-0, the Soviets leading. Lomachen trying to carry out. Yanni at the blue line, giving it to Gord Sherbin. Sherbin to Waters. And it's dumped in, and it's offside at the Soviet blue line. 8:13 to play. The Soviets leading Canada 3-0. We'll be right back.
Nowhere on earth but at the Bay will you find savings like this on Bomark Floor Care. Save 25% on all Bomark Floor Care, designed to pick up everything from dirt and fluff to stardust. Don't miss this sensational offer of 25% off Beaumont Floor Care, only at the Bay during Flying Colors. The sale's so great, it's out of this world.
Well, the Soviets here in the third period have scored a goal. They've outshot Canada 8-3. Here is Larionov with a drive just wide of the net. Now a loose puck chased after by Ken Berry or by Brian Bradley, it is. Bradley trying to get it in front, but there defensively was Stelnov. And now Kravchuk into center ice. to Stelnov as he moves on the attack. Got it in front. Cleared away by Waters. Soviets, Makarov in the grasp of Waters. And Bradley is back for Canada. Bradley over to Tony Stiles. Now to Yaremchuk. Up the middle to Tambellini. Got to center, but Kurutov knocked it down, and Larionov drops it back to Byakin. He gives it to Larionov. Soviets are playing that funny game. They won't give you the puck. Here's a long pass by Canada down the ice. And as Gusarov goes back to touch it, that's icing against Canada.
Well, I started to say earlier in the game that Canada had not scored a goal against the Soviet Union in the Olympics since 1980. They had a game in which they scored four, lost 6-4 in 1980. And the last one, too, there's a shot just wide of the net. Great, the outside of the post on Sean Burke. Burke will tell you he had it all the way. There's Igor Larionov. Let that shot go.
Soviets well on their way to their sixth straight victory in these Olympics. To this point, they've outscored the opposition 35-10. I think that's kind of a dominant statistic.
Well, last year in the medal, last Olympics in the medal round, they gave up only one goal in the medal round. And they look like they're going to be just as tough this time around. Of course, the guy in the goal that time was Tretiak.
Here's a loose puck knocked into center ice by Yashin. Going back after it, Zalapski for Canada. Canada trailing 3-0 and running out of time. Berry now pokes it to center. Tambellini races after it, but Kasatonov is there to clear it to center. And Canada drop it back to Zalapski. Now Randy Gregg to Malinowski, but Kasatonov there to intercept. Soviets. Svetlov into the zone. Dropping it back. Here's a chance for Semyonov, and his shot deflects and goes up over the glass into the crowd.
Sitting right down in front of our broadcast booth is the general manager of the Boston Bruins, Harry Sinden. Way back in 1960, I'm sure Harry Sinden left Squaw Valley very disappointed that he only got a silver medal. But he now, I'm sure, realizes just what that silver medal means. It has been a long, lean period since 1960. Canada has won only a bronze since, so they've never done as well. Harry was part of the Kitchener-Waterloo Dutchman team that went to the 1980 Olympics and finished second behind the United States.
Here's Kamienski for the Soviets trying to center it. Kamienski again does get it in front, but Sherman there for Canada fires it off the center ice to Billgraw. Billgraw headed out by Kropchuk, and Bekov, who's been all over the place tonight for the Soviets, comes up with it, and the Soviets come right back. Kamienski to Homotov, just tipped away by Yanni, and then he knocks Homotov to the ice in the corner. Homotov gets back up and continues the battle out in front to Kamienski, but Felix cleared it away. Here's Stelnov holding it in. And Canada fired around to Trent Yanni. 5.5 minutes left. 3-0 for the Soviets, who have stopped Canada cold here in the third period, and in the bargain scored another goal. Shot in by the Soviets. Mogilny into the corner with Stiles. Lomachen comes in. Now Mogilny gets his stick up with Stiles. They fence away. Now Lomachen and Poplinski battle, and Felix back to get the puck. Up the middle for Poplinski. Into Hampshire, but just tipped away by Gusarov. And here comes Mogilny over to Stelnov, to Lomachen. Back into Stelnov, into the corner. Centered. There's Mogilny in front, but just could get a stick on it. Hampshire back for Canada. To Poplinski. But he's taken out by Gusarov, and Milnikov cleared it away.
Dan, if you've ever been stuck in a traffic jam and you're getting frustrated and impatient and everybody is going the other way and you've got a flow to them, that's what the Canadians are facing right now. The Soviets have got a great flow. Every pass they're making is on the stick. They're skating with confidence. The Canadians are struggling. They feel like they're in a traffic jam and they're just spinning their wheels.
4:12 to play. Puck at center ice, and that's Larionov stepping up to break it up. Makarov in to take Greg out of the play. Makarov comes up with the puck. centered in front, just missed the oncoming Fetisov, and it comes back to Kasatonov. Now back in the Canadian zone, a little bit of a skirmish, Randy Gregg and Makarov, and I think we're going to get penalties against both here.
Well, right behind the play. They've been at it all day. I've seldom seen Randy Gregg as aggressive as he has been here. There's a holding and a roughing call being handed out. Makarov waits right to the bench, and Gregg following.
Well, a lot of rough rides, and Makarov, after Gregg had given him a rough ride, just took his feet out from under him.
Well, they've been holding, and the tempers are bound to get a little edgy.
Brad, I don't know if this third period reminds me as much of a traffic jam as it does a clinic, and the Soviets are really putting a clinic on. There you see Harry Sinden with Chicago GM Val Pofer.
As I say, not very many people know that Harry is a silver medalist in the Olympics. There's the business in front of the net. Finally, we had a Soviet lose his temper.
Holding against Gregg, tripping against Makarov, 16:04 the time. And it looks as though the Soviets are going to jump into first place in the medal round.
Well, they had to get the victory. At this moment, Finland's in first place. And with the 2 points here, the Soviets will move back in front by a point.
And Canada, with just only 1 point, in fifth place. And seeing their medal chances go slightly down the drain right here against the Soviets. Here's Fetisov into Larionov. Centered in front, they score! Karutov on as pretty a passing play as you will see.
That was just magic. That puck went 1, 2, 3 into the net.
Well, just a great play by the Soviets. Maybe it's the clinic Dan was talking about. Look here as they cross the line. Here's Larionov just finding Krutchev going to the net, and he redirects the puck. Ryan Bradley was on his tail. But Krutchev, if you ever try to check a fire plug, that's like trying to check him. You just can't get a good piece of him. And even if you do, you're going to be above him. He has got the low differential in weight where he's so strong and so low to the ice, you never get a good piece of him. A beautiful goal.
Krutchev, 6 of the Olympics from Larionov and Fetisov. 16:37 the time. 4-0 Soviets.
First time that the big green machine has been on the ice for a goal.
You know, Ron, 2 weeks ago this Friday, on our opening show from these Olympics, I talked about the Soviets coming back to the pack, that they weren't as good as they used to be. Should I apologize right here?
No, because I think that nobody could predict that a 2 or 3 players would suddenly rise above the play that they have put in the last couple of, the last 2 years, really. Fetisov has been back to the old Fetisov, the one that said he's maybe the best defenseman in the world. We've had Larionov playing far beyond the type of hockey we saw him play in the Canada Cup. Kurutov and Makarov, and some of these young players haven't played badly either, but they're the keys, and they've been controlling the game.
Puck is shot in, Hapscheid gets it to Sherman. He's tied up. Kambinski now coming up with it with 2.5 minutes remaining, and the Soviets leading 4-0. Kambinski got to center and has to circle back. Now to Gusarov, to Bekov, and it's dumped in by the Soviet Union, who have a big 4-0 lead. Waters to Zalewski, into center ice to Berry. Berry all by himself, and then ridden out of the play by Byakin. And the Soviets, Bekov, carries out of the zone. He gives it to Gusarov.
2 minutes of play in the game.
We're under 2 minutes remaining in a long night for Canada. And the Soviets have a 4-0 lead. Here is Waters getting it to center. Womackin knocks it down. Here's Makarov breaking away. In the clear, scores! Makarov makes it 5-0.
Well, all of a sudden, they're getting loose. Canada now has kind of come out of its checking game, and they're getting free on them. That makes it 5-0. Makarov.
If you want to see the strength of the Soviet players, now this guy is not a big guy. Makarov. Right now, Makarov, watch him go here. Watch him take the slash right there. Boom, and he just cuts back. I mean, he did not move. He did exactly what he wanted. A small guy, but tremendously strong.
Now the question is, will they get the shutout? And if the Soviets do, in the last, in the seven meetings between Canada and the Soviet Union in Olympic history, it will be the fourth time the Soviets have shut Canada out. It goes right back to 1956, when a goaltender named Puchkov was in there for the Soviet Union. In 1968 at Grenoble, it was Konovalenko. In 1984, Tretiak. And now it would appear, with 1:33 left, the name will be Mushkin. Or Milnikov, rather.
Here's another look at it. Here's where he takes the slash and the cross check. And believe me, he did not move an inch. What a strong man.
Well, the Soviets are going to jump to the top of the pack with 6 points. Finland with 5. Sweden 4. Germany 2. Canada 1. Czechoslovakia nothing. What does that leave left for Canada with two games to play?
Well, two games are against Germany and Czechoslovakia. And looking at the games those two teams played today, Canada is capable of winning those games. If they do, they would have 5 points. Now they need some help. Sweden will be playing Germany. They're ahead of Canada. Germany, well, we don't know. Canada, at this point, needs some help to get third, has a good chance of being fourth in the tournament.
Here's Tambellini shooting it in, and that's offside at the Soviet blue line. The last scoring play, Makarov, Brumlow Mackin, 18-16 the time, to make it 5-0.
The Swedes have a game against Germany, and they have a game against the Soviet Union, and that's the key. If Sweden somehow lost both of those games and Canada won both of its games, they would get a bronze medal. But it is, as I say, they're going to need some help, especially from West Germany. And of course, they have to beat West Germany themselves, and West Germany has had good nights and obviously bad nights. They had a bad night this particular day.
1:06 to play. The Soviets 5, Canada nothing. Raining on the parade a little bit here in Calgary tonight, the Soviets. Against the host country's hockey club, here's a lead pass to Hrabchuk in center ice. Firing it to Larionov. Felix is there. Over to Randy Gregg in Canada. Come to center, and that's called back on a two-line offside, and then Mr. Vilgraw and Mr. Hrabchuk differ on something.
Well, Canada, we talked about being shut out. They've been shut out now by the Soviets over 100 minutes. Two straight games plus about 13 minutes of a game in which, by the way, Canada tied the Soviets 4-4. This was at Lake Placid. And then a couple of late goals by the Soviets allowed them to win.
Ice stick. That stops play, and they'll move the faceoff into the Soviet zone. No taking anything away from the Soviet machine tonight, Ron.
Well, they've been great. They withstood a lot of pressure that Canada put on them. They're difficult. Dave King was counting on them losing their poise. That was the one thing he said, that if we can get their goat, in effect, we might be able to take advantage of that. The Soviets did not allow anybody to get their goat, if you'll forgive the expression.
Since the first period, the Soviets have been in control. Here's Schreiber in the corner, trying to center, getting it to Malinowski. Got it in front, but there's Makarov with 18 seconds left, and Makarov flies out of his own zone and just drops it back to the defenseman, Bjorken. They're protecting the shutout for their goaltender in this game, Sergei Milnikov. Puck cleared down the ice. Gregg back to get it with 1 second left. Just time for a faceoff in the Soviet end of the rink, and I'm sure everyone would just have soon seen that final second tick off.
Well, shutouts seem to be the norm in the medal round. Of the all the games played in the medal round last Olympics, there were four shutouts. There were only four games played in the medal round, and four shutouts. Two of the three now in this medal round have been shutouts. And there it is, another one.
A long evening for Canada comes to an end, and the Soviets go 6-0. They outshoot Canada 33-17. Yashin, Bekov, Mogilny, Kurutov, and Makarov score. Milnikov gets the shutout. The Soviets dominant here tonight, and they defeat Canada 5-0 at the Saddle Dome. The final score, Soviets 5, Canada nothing.
Ball and other city center stops along 6th Avenue. Buses leave from gate 4.
Well, they're streaming out of the Saddle Dome just across the road from where we are, rather disconsolate group. Naturally, because the USSR defeated Canada tonight 5-0. That puts the Soviet Union in top spot in the battleground play. They have 6 points. Finland has 5, Sweden 4, West Germany 2, Canada 1, Czechoslovakia nothing. The next game for Canada is on Friday morning.